growing up in this area, seeing those twin towers every day, and losing some friends and some acquaintances, and you know, we never forget that and never want it to be forgotten. And I'm just gonna do a couple of songs here that some covers and one original. Send us out to the memory of all those that lost their lives in the World Trade Center, whether they were working there or first responders, or all the folks afterwards that died from 9/11 related, you know, illnesses and cancers and that stuff, and everybody that was affected by it. Let's send these out to y'all. Where were you when the world stopped turning on that September day? Out in the yard with your wife and children, working on some stage in LA. Did you stand there in shock at the sight of that black smoke rising up against that blue sky? Did you shout out in anger and fear for your neighbor? Did you just sit down and cry? Did you weep for the children that lost their dear loved one? Pray for the ones that don't know. Did you rejoice for the people who walk from the rubble and sob for the ones left below? Burst out with pride for the red, white, and blue, for the heroes who died just doing what they do. You look up to heaven and search for an answer. Look at yourself and what really matters. I'm just a singer of simple songs. I'm not a real political man. I watch CNN, but I don't know. I can tell you the difference in Iraq and Iran. But I know Jesus and I talk to God, and I remember this when I was young. Faith, hope, and love were some good things He gave us, but the greatest is love. Where were you when the world stopped turning on that September day? Teaching a class full of innocent children, or driving down the cold interstate? Did you feel guilty 'cause you're a survivor? In a crowded room, do you feel alone? Did you call up your mother and tell her you loved her? Or dust off your old Bible at home? Did you open your eyes, hope it didn't happen? Close your eyes and not fall asleep. Did you notice the sunset for the first time in ages? Speak to a stranger on the street. Did you lay down at night, think of tomorrow? Did you go out and buy you a gun? Did you turn off that old violent movie you're watching? Turn on I Love Lucy reruns. Did you go to a church and hold hands with a stranger? Stand in line to give your own blood? Did you just stay at home and cling to your family? Be thankful you got someone to love. I'm just a singer of simple songs. I'm not a real political man. I watch CNN, but I'm not sure I could tell you the difference in Iraq and Iran. But I know Jesus and I talk to God. I remember this from when I was young. Faith, hope, and love were some great things He gave us. The greatest is love. And the greatest is love. Where were you when the world stopped turning on that September day.
That's Alan Jackson. Wrote that after 9/11. This is one I wrote back in 2015. I went to, I'm friends with a band up here, Country Comfort, and I went to go see them play in Clifton, New Jersey, is where, and that's where I grew up. And I don't know, the day I left, I walked out of work and somebody had up a picture of the, you know, the twin beams of light that are there now at Ground Zero. And, you know, I got down in Clifton and I'm a Vince Lombardi guy, so I was way early. And I was just sitting there looking at the New York skyline and pulled out a piece of paper and wrote this down. It's called Twin Beams of Light. Skyline greeted me each day. For 15 straight years, the sun threw a chime. Though I moved elsewhere, it's etched in my mind. On 9/11, a cowardly blow killed many thousands and laid those towers low. Though they wanted us to succumb to our fears, our nation's resolve rose through the smoke and tears. Now there's twin beams of light where the twin towers stood. I'll never forget them, nobody should. Where our friends and first responders perished in flame, we gather to honor each of them by name. A constant reminder of those that we lost, and that we protect freedom no matter what the cost. When I see that New York skyline now, I see a gaping hole, and patriotic anger starts to fill my soul. They died in Manhattan, Pennsylvania, and our Pentagon. Now it's our duty, their memories to carry on. Though it may not be perfect from sea to shining sea, this country's still the greatest because we are still free. And when you look upon Manhattan on any given night, those twin beams should remind you of why we have to fight. Now there's twin beams of light where the twin towers stood. I'll never forget them, nobody should. Where our friends and first responders perished in flames, we gather to honor each of them by name. A constant reminder of those that we lost, and that we protect freedom no matter what the cost. Now there's twin beams of light where the twin towers
stood. I'll never forget them, nobody should.
None of us should forget that, and we should keep it not only in our memories, make sure it gets passed down to everybody after us so it's never forgotten. It's a Daryl Worley tune.
I hear people saying we don't need this war. I say there's some things worth fighting for. What about our freedom and this piece of ground? Didn't get to keep it by backing down. They say we don't realize the mess we're getting in. Before you start your preaching, let me ask you this, my friend. Have you forgotten how it felt that day? See your homeland under fire and our people blown away. Have you forgotten when those towers fell? We had neighbors still inside going through a living hell. And you say we shouldn't worry about Bin Laden. Have you forgotten? Took all the footage off my TV. Said it's too disturbing for you and me. It'll just bring anger, it's what the experts say. If it was up to me, I'd show it every day. Some say this country's just out looking for a fight. After 9/11, man, I'd have to say they're right. Have you forgotten how it felt that day to see a home under fire and our people blown away? Have you forgotten when those towers fell? We had neighbors still inside going through a living hell. And you tell me you shouldn't worry about Bin Laden. Have you forgotten? Been there with the soldiers who've gone away to war, and you can bet that they remember just what we're fighting for. Have you forgotten all the people killed? Yes, some went down like heroes in that Pennsylvania field. Have you forgotten about a Pentagon, all the loved ones that we lost and those left to carry on? Don't you tell me not to worry about Bin Laden. Have you forgotten? Have you forgotten? I hear people saying don't need this war. I say there's some things worth fighting for.
So it's a Daryl Worley tune here. I'm going to cover this next one. It's a friend of mine from Nashville. I'm not sure that he wrote it, but I know he released it. It's called "That's What My Daddy's Fighting For." I heard him sing this in one of the bars down in Nashville, and picked up his CD and been friends with him ever since. He's got a tremendous voice. You look him up. Paul Pace.
Little girl stood up in school, asked if she could speak. In a trembling voice she spoke these words as tears rolled down her cheek. My daddy's gone to a foreign land to fight an awful war. Here's what my daddy's fighting for. country one September day. They changed our lives forever, couldn't take our pride away. As we still live in freedom like we always have before. Here's what my daddy's fighting for. We see people on TV marching in our towns. Mama said they're doing things to bring our leaders down. Don't they understand the damage that they do? Can't they see my daddy's fighting for them too? I know I'm just a kid, but I still know wrong from right. And what they're trying to do is why my daddy's gone to fight. And he'll come home to a country even stronger than before. That's what my daddy's fighting for. We see people on TV marching in our towns. Mama said they're doing things to bring our leaders down. Don't they understand the damage that they do? Can't they see my daddy's fighting for them too? I know I'm just a kid, but I still know wrong from right. And what they're trying to do is why my daddy's gonna fight. He'll come home to a country even stronger than before. That's what my daddy's fighting for. The little girl stood up in school and asked if she could speak.
All right, folks, going to do one more for you here on this 9/11 holiday. And I know it's, if you're like me, it's a mix of somberness and a mix of anger. And there's no other way to put it. Anger, patriotic anger, still pisses me off. You know, all these years later, 22 years later. And this is a Toby Keith song, and I think this sums up the way a lot of us felt right after that.
American girls and American guys will always stand up and salute. We'll always recognize when we see old glory flying. There's a lot of men dead, so we can sleep in peace at night when we lay down our heads. My daddy served in the army. He lost his right eye, but he flew a flag out in our yard till the day that he died. Wanted my mother, my brother, my sister and me to grow up and live happy in the land of the free. Now this nation that I love is falling under attack. A mighty sucker punch came flying in from somewhere in the back. Soon as we could see clearly through our big black eye, man, we lit up your world like the 4th of July. Hey, Uncle Sam, put your name at the top of his list. The Statue of Liberty started shaking her fist, and the eagle will fly, and it's gonna be hail. When you and your mother freedom start ringing her bell, it'll feel like the whole wide world's raining down on you. Served and the battle will rage. This big dog will fight when you rattle his cage. You'll be sorry that you messed with the U.S. of A. We'll put a boot in your ass. It's the American way. Hey, Uncle Sam, put your name at the top of his list. The Statue of Liberty started shaking her fist, and the eagle will fly, and it's gonna be hell when you hear Mother Freedom start ringing a bell. It'll feel like the whole wide world raining down on you. Brought to you courtesy of the red, white, and blue.
Thank you all for listening, and like I said, my thoughts and prayers go with all those we lost that day, and everyone's been affected by it, whether, you know, post-traumatic, the cancers and the sicknesses that happened afterwards, those that lost friends, family, and, you know, send that memory out to some schoolmates and some acquaintances and other folks I knew and some relatives of folks that I knew that were impacted that day. I remember when I got back home, passing the train station, and at the time I lived in Tawako, and I lived across the street from the Tawako train station, and there were just cars covered in flowers. It was, sadness, somberness, and anger is the only things I can really feel out of it. So, God bless, and God bless America.